All right, so the next sheet I'm going to go over here is the end of night sheet. And this is basically your summary of what happened for the whole day. So as you can see, all these numbers are in here, and they come, all these numbers get drawn from all the DSR, the flash, and the hour sheet. So all you're filling in is, was there a deposit made today? Yes or no? Who made that deposit? Curtis. These are our sales, which these sales, as you can see up here, they come from the flash report. They're not, it's not something that you have to put in. This comes from the DSR. This comes from the DSR. This comes from your hours when you set your budget. So it's all filtering into this end of night. Your week to day is again from your hours sheet. Your week to day of last year is from your hours sheet or your DSR. And then the variance is obviously one minus the other. So this is saying this year we did this much, last year we did that much. Here's our variance. So we're up $1,500 on the week. We're up $1,500 on the period because we're considering this the first day, week eight, or period eight, week one, day one. So whatever we're up on the day, we're up on the period too. Or the week, we're up on the period. The Aloha manager is how much your deposit is saying, you know, what they're saying your deposit is. Manager on duty is your closing manager on duty. Did you close the EDC? That's your batch. So did you run your credit cards?
Is the Aloha manager automatically entered?
Automatically, automatically entered from the DSR. And another big thing is when you're doing this stuff, you always want to look at the top box up here because, you know, if you scroll over something and it has equals DSR flash, don't ever put anything in there because you can. And let me see if it's.
Can you erase the formula?
Yeah, you can erase the formula. I'm going to try to protect these, but just, you know, always be aware of what's already there and the fact that you might not have to enter anything. So just don't go typing stuff. You want to look for a blank slate like this.
Exactly.
So, all right, this bottom part is basically your summary of the day. So how was the weather? I put really short stuff here, but, you know, normally I would say, you know, it was 90 degrees, very humid. We had showers from 2 to 4. Nighttime it cooled off. It was 80 degrees. So, you know, we had some good weather at night. Purchases, this pulls from the flash, what was all put in that day, so they know how much we purchased that day. Then lunch, this pulls from when we put our sales into the DSR. Then this is very important. You know, for lunch, you want to put, you know, it was a slower lunch. You know, obviously we see the numbers, you know, Anthony's going to see the numbers, Tarek's going to see the numbers. They know that $250 is a slow lunch. But the big thing for here is why was it a slow lunch? It was very hot out. You know, students are out for summer. There aren't many people in town right now. So our lunch was slower than normal. Dinner. You know, we had great weather tonight. And we're running $9.99 specials, which caused us to have a pretty good dinner for a Monday night. Also, we had a birthday party come in, which was a 15 top, which really boosted our sales a little bit. So what happens is next year, when you come to period 8, week 1, if there's a number in a day that's off, you pull this up and the manager's told you why that was like that. Oh, we were low in sales because we had a hurricane this weekend. You know, so we did $1,000 because hurricane, you know, Hugo came through and freaking everyone had to stay inside and we had to close the restaurant down or whatever. So basically this is just so when you're doing your projections, you can look back on this. Obviously right now you guys don't have this to look back on, but you can pull your hourly sales reports and, you know, figure it out.
Anything that, so if next year, like, why did we do sales so high last year or so low, you can.
And weather's a huge thing and, you know, there was a concert or graduation or the first week of school or anything. Any, you know, someone ran a promotion. We had a private group in and they did a party. Anything that affects your sales, you want it to go in here.
So for lunch, should the lunch manager on duty go in before he leaves that day and enter all that in?
Yep.
Maybe Maybe we can add like a late night one or something my reporter.
You could add a late night, or you could just, you know, it's here, it says dinner night. Okay, so you could do dinner, and then you could just add on a little late night message in there. You could do it all together. I mean, it's just going to get ripped. So you've done everything. So all this stuff's filled out. All of it looks good. You're going to copy this. Hold on, I just lost it. Yeah.
Oh, you use command on Apple's instead of control.
You're going to copy this. Go to your Gmail.
Send that as the email.
And you're just gonna do this. Compose mail to Anthony. You gotta get my email address, which we'll get for you guys. Tarek. You can actually make a group called like managers, you know, and if you create a group, then you can just type like 101 managers and it'll put everyone's email in there. But for right now, I'm just going to do Tarek and Anthony. And then I always do 101, end of night, 8/1/11. Then you're going to paste it. Now you want to, does this give you paste options? There you go. You just paste it in there, and then they can read it and see how the night went. So this is how the body of the email will look. And sort of page down on these guys. I hate Max. So you could page down this, and they can view, and they're going to be able to see everything that happened. So, you know, what this does is this lets everyone know what's going on in the restaurant, which is very important. And that way, the whole goal is that Tarek and Anthony don't need to be here every day, that you guys can run and, you know, they can see everything. And if they go, oh, shit, we only did $1,000 last night, then they can call and say, hey, what happened last night? You know, or it's already in there and they know what happened.
We have days where they deliver stuff. Like Mondays is the big bulk of days of delivering stuff like that.
I know the kitchen gets deliveries every day.
Oh, really?
As far as like produce wise, they get produce every day. Liquor's only Tuesday and Friday.
All right, so
Tuesday will be in your
office. Right, and here's the thing. The way the flash will work and all this stuff will work is, like, this is just what they're going to see. They don't see the flash and everything. They just see this. And then they're going to understand that the flash is going to be your pace percent will be really, really low, and then Friday and Saturday you don't get anything in, and those are your two big days, so... You know, you do 25 grand in those 2 days and you don't take in any product, you know, your pace will go from like negative 30 to positive 30 in, you know, 2 days.
That's average of the whole week.
So all this stuff builds up to the week and then to the end of the week. All right.